Have you ever heard of Bodhi Chandro? He is one of the pioneers of stand-up paddleboarding in Canada. So today we're going to learn about what we can do this summer to tone our core, our shoulders. We're going to be stand-up paddleboarding machines in just a few moments with Bodhi.
Okay, are you ready?
I'm all set.
On either side, you get your stability.
So how did you get hooked on this stand-up paddleboarding? How did you hear about it?
You know what? I've been a lifetime surfer, flat water paddler, white water paddler, and a bit of a fitness junkie. And all of a sudden, I was introduced to the sport a couple of years ago in California, and it really encompassed every single passion that I have in my life. So I literally got on board and haven't looked back since. It's actually the fastest growing water sport in the world right now, so it's just starting to go mainstream. The reason for its popularity really is its ease of entry. Anybody can learn to stand up paddleboard, regardless of age or physical ability. Everybody can experience walking on water.
What kind of benefits can I look forward to if I were to do this two or three times a week?
Oh, the physical benefits are fantastic. Again, utilizing smaller muscle groups for paddling, your core for paddling, isometrically your quadriceps. You can work your balance. It's great cross training for just about every sport out there that you could possibly do. Plus, it has the whole soul of the sport. It's very tranquil. It's very stress reducing. It's the complete package.
So how many hours at a time might you go out for?
Well, we casually paddle, you go out for a half an hour. I go out and I train for up to 3 hours some days, depending on the weather this summer. But, you know, it all depends what you want to get out of it. Oftentimes, my wife and I will jump in the water on the boards after supper and go for a paddle down the lake for an hour instead of going out for a walk on the trail. So it really is whatever you desire. Great, Shelley.
So
we're going to start on the dock. First thing, important part of the board, this is the carry handle, and I want you to utilize it as reference for where we're going to place our feet on either side of the carry handle when we rise into the standing position. We go to get on the board, we're going to be kneeling with that carry handle between our legs. We always want, just like in mountain climbing, we want to have 3 points of contact to the board. So you're going to lean forward on your hands, holding your paddle. You're going to roll up on your toes, and then you're going to slowly bring one foot under the other and rise into a standing position. Grab the T-grip on the paddle, casually paddle away. We want to be in an athletic standing position, our ankles bent, our knees bent, our chest up, our eyes looking forward, and the most important thing is breathe.
It's the breathing that you forget to do. Now, how many times a week do I have to come out and do this until I actually feel confident and get good at it?
You know what, you'd be amazed. Most of my students, within 1 hour on the water, it's a completely different feeling. You'll have a tremendous amount of confidence, and oftentimes I'll get them back a week later for an advanced class or come out for one of my fitness classes.
What kind of results would I be able to expect?
How about a six-pack in 6 months?
Six-pack in 6 months? I love it. Okay, I'm floating away. Wait, where can we get more information, Bodhi?
You can check out my website, paddlesurfit.com. That's paddlesurfit.com.
Thanks,
Aloha.
Bodhi.
Aloha.
Aloha.